Dear Mrs. Sawan, thank you so much for everything these past 4 years. I'm so grateful to have had you in class, both as a source of inspiration and knowledge. You have so much passion for what you do, something that is made clear to everyone who is privileged enough to be taught by you. I have truly come to love Latin, something that I give the credit for exclusively to you. You truly love each one of your students. This genuine care is so sweet and shows through in everything that you do. You take whatever time you have in order to help a student understand better and find confidence in what they are learning. Any time that I have been in need of your assistance, you have been more than willing to provide it, for which I am eternally grateful. I'm especially thankful for your help in preparing for the SAT subject test. I really enjoyed taking the time to prepare for the test, and I learned so much in those few weeks. Taking that time not only prepared me for Latin 4 this year, but it really reminded me of how beautiful the Latin language is. I love learning the complexities that come along with the language, and combining that with your passion for the subject, it is hard not to become engrossed in readings. Mrs. Sawan, I am so thankful for everything, and I am sad I can't have you as a teacher for the rest of my life. But I know that everything you have taught me, whether it be about Latin or simply about life, will remain with me forever. I hope that I can carry out my life with at least a fraction of the passion that I see within you, and I'm so grateful that I have you as inspiration. Sincerely, Claire.
Between everything I did in elementary and middle school to equip myself for freshman year, nothing could prepare me for Mr. Ehler's 7th, 8th period honors biology class. On the first day of school, I had no idea that some of the most unforgettable components of my high school experience would be this class and Mr. Ehler? Ehler? Although the class had trouble pronouncing his name right the first time, he was quick to correct us, as well as explain why biology would be the most important class we'd ever take. "It's the study of life!" he exclaimed as he pointed to the board, complete with these words and several meme-worthy pictures. From this moment on, I knew I'd be in for an interesting ride. One thing that stuck out to me about Mr. Ehler was his sense of humor. He'd always make class fun by saying silly things to help us remember the material. He took the time to get to know each of his students and would often poke fun at them whenever the chance was presented. In our class, one of these students was named Hunter. Hunter was so popular in these lighthearted endeavors that a sweepstakes was named after him. Whenever we would choose partners for an assignment, Mr. Ehler would pull out a deck of note cards with our names on them. As he shuffled the deck, a wide grin appeared on his face as he questioned, "Oh boy, who's gonna win the Hunter sweepstakes today?" Whenever Hunter's name was pulled, the class would hold their breath and commence a drum roll to see who his lucky partner would be. Moments like these brought a comedic tone to the class that made me look forward to it every day. Another attribute about Mr. Ehler I appreciated was his ability to interact with his students. His friendly personality and amiable demeanor made his classroom a welcoming environment. He even gave some of his students nicknames, including me. For whatever reason, he preferred to call me by my last name even more than my first. Even after I left his class, Mr. Ehler still continued using this nickname. I remember being late to, ironically, science class on the first day of the next school year. As I was frantically running to the room, Mr. Ehler spotted me and shouted, "Stop farthing!" across the hallway. Biology class was always accompanied by conversation, smiles, and laughter, all thanks to Mr. Ehler. Finally, Mr. Ehler never failed to motivate his students to do their best in his class. Although the material could be difficult, he urged us to never give up and keep trying. Not every test score was fantastic, but I can attest to the fact that I always put in a lot of effort, and thanks to his encouragement, it paid off. Between the reasons listed above and many more, I can easily say that Mr. Ehler is one of the best teachers I've ever had. Mr. Ehler, thank you for everything. You've taught me how to unlock my true potential through hard work and determination, which has inspired me to give 100% in everything I do. You've made me laugh as well as given me a strong appreciation for seafood, especially grits. Most of all, you've showed me what an intriguing world we live in and why we must protect it. Once again, thank you for caring and providing me with many happy memories, and I hope your legacy can continue to impact students for years to come. Sincerely, Melissa Farthing. P.S. From the time of reading, there are only 227 more days until the next Star Wars movie. Get hyped!
This teacher doesn't care about your grades, he doesn't care about your whining, and he certainly hopes you are a vegetarian so there's more bacon in the world for himself. Putting all this aside, he hates all of his students equally, which of course is just another way of saying he loves all of his students equally. No other teacher in this school could truthfully say that. All joking aside, Mr. Matthews is by far one of the most amazing teachers at Medina High School. He truly teaches all of his materials clearly and efficiently. He will be sure to answer all your questions, go through any practice problems you're struggling with, and make sure to give you the tools you need to do well in math. He truly wants his students to learn the materials to the best of their ability. My hatred for math is not unknown in his class, but his teaching makes calculus bearable, as I can always get clarification on any topic I am struggling with. Freshman year, when I had him for honors geometry, I had a pretty severe concussion and was out of school for an extended period of time. But no matter how far behind I became, he was always there to give me my work and offer up time outside of class to help me when I was struggling. It was immensely helpful to have a teacher who cared about helping to catch me up in my schoolwork, no matter how far behind I fell. Now, having him as a senior, I can still see how much effort he puts in his students who care about their success. But if you know anything about Mr. Matthews, you know his sense of humor is hilarious. Once everyone in class has fully understood his lesson, we as a class have the best conversations about anything and everything. Everyone in the class loves making fun of me for my love of the environment. Mr. Matthews knows how to push my buttons and plays devil's advocate just to annoy me every day. Plastic straws, fertilizer runoff, and carbon emission problems are usually the butt of every joke. But we as a class have had so much fun laughing and engaging in conversation. We have also have had several best sock contests between Logan and, what's his name? Discussed the best military discounts in Medina, and overall have just had a blast every day. Mr. Matthews makes his class both fun and engaging, while also covering all the topics we need to learn. I will miss his class and teaching immensely next year. Thank you, Mr. Matthews, for being such a great teacher. You know you will miss annoying me next year. Sincerely, Sydney Lally, the environmentalist.